concept for a surf trainer, which brings it back to what Carver originally started as, which was, you know, a way to be able to pump and practice for surfing. So at one point it was this big trampoline with this big thing on it, and often it was just a mysterious mechanism that really hadn't quite worked out. Here we go. Here's the original genesis for some of the early drawings, where it shows a trailing wheel and some kind of a swing arm system. So back in 96, you know, Greg and I were surfing a lot, trying to figure out how to make a skateboard that felt like a surfboard. And trying to figure out how the trucks worked was a real big conundrum for us. And after a lot of surfing and a lot of skating, we started to come up with this idea that what really needed to happen was that the back truck needed to be a bit more stable, and the front trunk needed to have this swing arm that would allow you to basically rotate the nose in such a way that the path and travel of the front truck was more than that of the back truck. So this was one of the early prototypes that really hit on success. And we had figured out that we needed this front swiveling motion. And we also figured out that we needed the secondary axis here in order to make it feel really fluid. But the spring mechanism on such a small machine was pretty hard to come up with, that could take the amount of beating that a skateboard truck takes. So for a while we had this adjustable bungee cord on there to kind of give it this spring back. And then we started to experiment with some internal spring mechanisms that would fit underneath the arm and were adjustable as well. This was a prototype we rode around for a long time. Lots of different ways to come up with a spring mechanism that controlled the arm that was adjustable. There were so many options we went through, we didn't want to leave any behind. Over the years of development, you know, we really did go through a whole range of different kinds of truck mechanisms, all based on the same basic principle, but each one a slight improvement over the next. One of the great challenges was this arm. Lots of holes, lots of functions to it. Another one of the great challenges was something that went together and came apart really easily. So it's this secondary axis that really gives the front nose of the board the movement that it needs in order to perform like a surfboard. And this internal spring system is what brings the arm back and gives you the energy to pump it. And this is the C7 as we make it now at our factory in El Segundo. As a matter of fact, the factory is only 15 minutes away. Let's go check it out. A lot of these alleys have served as great inspiration for our surf skating. It's a whole lot of banks, all kinds of driveways. Nobody's paying any attention to what we're doing in the alley, so we can just have a good time and skate.